This video is brought to you by Squarespace. In this video, we're gonna see how you can create the zoom through device effect in Final Cut Pro 10 without any plugins required. This is the part one of a two-part series, and today we're watching on how we can create this effect by having recorded first the first video with a device, which is watching the video, and you will see later on in Final Cut what I mean. And the second part, which is gonna be published later on, is gonna be how we can create this effect if we don't have a footage with a device which is playing the video. So if you are watching this video in a later phase, right now, you probably will see the link for the part 2 up here. Let's go into Final Cut Pro 10 and see how we can create the zoom through device effect. We are in the Final Cut Pro 10 interface, and I have placed the video where I sat the iPad, which is showing the Venice video, and also I have placed the actual Venice video, and as you can see here, I made the same frame, I cut it on the same frame, so we can create. The first thing that we want to do is, first of all, to go and create the zoom through the iPad device. How we're gonna do that? We will go into the end of the video of the iPad, and by pressing the left arrow in my keyboard, I will count 10 frames. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, from here, I will go into the inspector panel and I will add a keyframe on scale to all, a keyframe to the anchor, and a keyframe to the rotation. Now, I will go into the end of the video, and I did that by pressing the down arrow in my keyboard. I will go one frame to the left so I can see exactly what's happening to the end, and I'm gonna drag the scale all so I can bring the video zoomed. Also, I will change the rotation, and I'm gonna drag the y-axis on the anchor and the x to bring it to the center. Again, you will adjust all of these numbers so you can make it the video on the iPad to match exactly the screen. Alright, and as you can see here, we're pretty okay to go. If I can make it 442 so we don't have any empty spaces here. And by doing that, you will see that already I have created the zoom through. Perfect. Now, we need to make the transition to the actual footage, because you see here, it's a little bit more bigger, and I want it to make from bigger to the actual size of the video. We can either change to 440, and we will see again that it's a little bit zoom in. As soon as I finish with that, I will click on the actual Venice clip, and I will press Command Option and the top arrow in my keyboard so I can lift it from the storyline. Then I'm gonna count one frame to the left by pressing the left arrow in my keyboard, and I'm gonna drag the clip on top. Next step is going to the inspector panel, and I'm gonna lower the opacity so I can see exactly what the match is gonna be. As you can see, I have to scale a little bit so I can match the whole scene. You can adjust the settings to be as close to the initial clip as possible. You can adjust how zoomed is going to be, and also you can change the anchor Y and X so you can match your scene. And when you are as close as possible, you will add a keyframe to the scale all and also to the anchor on the inspector panel here on the right. You will add also a keyframe on the opacity, and you can lower the opacity to 30 or 40%. We can go to 30%. And you will go one frame to the right by pressing right arrow in your keyboards. Actually, when the next video is gonna start playing, and then you will change the opacity to 100%, the scale all to 100%, and the anchor to 0. So you can center the whole video again into the center. Let me just take a break and talk a little bit about Squarespace, today's episode sponsor. If you don't know who Squarespace is an all-in-one platform where you can get your domain or build your own website without having any knowledge at all at web design or web developing. If you're a creative, artist, freelancer, videographer, photographer, you know that having a website is a must. It's the way to having an online presence and also showcasing your portfolio. So if you don't have a website and you were thinking to get one, head over to squarespace.com/Emilio. You can try it for free first. And when you're ready to buy, you can use the coupon code Emilio and get 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain. Now let's go back into the video. But two things are still missing. So what we're gonna do is, first of all, to work with our audio. We want the audio from the iPad. It's gonna have a little bit of a distance. It's gonna be lower and it's gonna have a higher volume when we're in the actual video, we are zoomed in our video. So we will select the actual clip. We're gonna right click and click on detach audio. We're gonna drag all the audio. We will select the audio. We will change the volume to minus 15. And when we're starting to go into our new clip, here in the beginning, we're gonna add a keyframe. We will move 1, 2 frames to the right. I don't want to be one frame, but we can do 2 frames so we can have a little bit of transition. And I'm gonna change the volume to 0. And then the last thing that you need to do is to add motion blur into the transition. You will find the file of the motion blur that I'm using on this tutorial, free for you to download in the description of this video down below. And also you can find the links for the ET Motion Blur Advanced plugin that I have created for Final Cut Pro 10. So let's go. We're going into titles. I'm gonna select the ET Motion Blur High. This works as an adjustment layer. I'm gonna drag the motion blur adjustment layer into the beginning of the transition. I'm gonna go where it's gonna end. I'm gonna press B in my keyboard and I'm gonna cut it. I'm gonna select it and delete it. If you wanna make your transition a little bit more blurred, you can also select the motion blur adjustment layer. You can go into the inspector panel and on the published parameters, you can change the amount of the zoom blur, let's say to 5, so you're gonna have a better effect on it. And if you want to spice it a little bit more, you can add some sound design, some sound effects. A whoosh file will work just fine. So I'm gonna have the whoosh sound effect just where the transition begins and ends. I'm gonna lower a little bit the volume. I'm using Epidemic Sounds for my sound effects and also a lot of my music on the channel. And you can try Epidemic Sound for free for 30 days if you click on the link that you see in the description of this video. So the final results with the sound effects, the motion blur, the audio, and the transition is gonna look like this. I hope you found this video helpful and you learned something new today. I'm waiting your comments to let me know what you like, what you didn't like, and if you have any questions on this effect, don't forget to like this video, subscribe to my channel for more content like this one. Thank you so much for watching, stay safe, I'm Emilio Takas, and I will see you in the next video.